surf, surf, hey. Surf, surf, crazy, baby. Surf, surf, crazy. Ride the perfect way. Say hi to the sky. Surf, surf, hey. It's a bikini wonderland. 2013 was the birth of one of our most legendary movies. A movie that comes close to the ranks of the best Disney Channel movies of all time with High School Musical. That's mad. Just imagine me, a young chap, a sexy chap, just in the ends, yeah, trying to make it out. Just finished year 3, ready for grade 4, the big boy leagues. But before that, having the summer holiday and, you know, putting on Disney Channel. And the movie that came on was none other than Team Beach Movie. Hi, I'm OhMarDayz, and you're watching Disney Channel. Actually, it's me commentating over Team Beach Movie after I haven't watched it for a while, but you know, you get it. Let's just get into it, lads. Team Beach Movie was a 2013 classic which starred Maya Mitchell and internet sensation Austin Moon. I mean, it was Ross Lynch, but you guys get it, man. Come on. The movie begins with some cheesy music, the cast members' names, and in the background, Mac and Brady having the surf of their life. Hey, get in there, lad! After they have the surf of their life, the cheesy music's done and all of that, Mac wants to tell Brady something, but all Bossman cares about is the waves, dude.
Awesome. Surfing all day, us being together. Awesome wishes. It was just awesome.
Yeah, it was perfect.
Yeah, it was.
Listen, Brady.
Ooh, did you hear about tomorrow?
Yeah! Can you believe they're talking about 40-foot waves?
So she proceeds to try and tell him again, but Bossman doesn't know how to shut the fuck up and let your girlfriend speak. So he decides to go and watch his favorite movie with her grandpa.
Please tell me this isn't
West Side Story!
A cheeky little brofist right there. But yeah, his favorite movie is a B-Tech version of West Side Story. A beautiful movie inspired by Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, just turned into a movie about surfers and bikers and them not getting their hair wet when they put it in water. No, I don't know, man.
1962, surfers, bikers, best movie ever made.
How can you two like this silliness, especially you, Grandpa?
Silliness? Mac, my dear, this movie defined an entire culture.
Exactly.
Yeah.
A surfer guy and a biker girl share a secret love while trying to unite their rivaling gangs as an evil real estate mogul tries to turn their hangout into a resort by building a weather machine which blows up, creating a massive storm. Silliness? Really?
Now you know, it makes perfect sense in it.
Ocean and never spit out water.
Surprise. Well, aren't you going to give your Aunt Antoinette a hug?
So out of the blue, Mac's aunt comes to go and collect her for tomorrow's big day of her going to boarding school. Which was the thing Mac was trying to like get out of her chest this whole time, but Brady wouldn't shut the F up.
It's good to see you, Mackenzie.
What are you doing here? I thought you were coming tomorrow.
Well, you thought wrong. We are leaving tomorrow. I hope you packed.
Mac, what does she mean by leaving tomorrow?
Well, Brady, if you follow this technique we learn in school or in life in general, where we shut the fuck up and listen to someone, maybe you would have known.
Stop! What was this deal your aunt was talking about?
After we lost my mom, the deal I made with my aunt was that I could stay here with my grandfather for the first part of high school. And then when it was time to get serious, I would leave with my aunt and go to the school, like she did.
So she just shows up to take you away? Aren't you happy here?
It's my mom's journal.
My nigga, that wasn't the question. There's something you're gonna realize as you watch the movie. Every time there's a question thrown out, the other person wants to just change the subject, and you'll realize it as the movie goes along.
You don't have to be where your aunt is. Mac, you can be anything you want.
Brady, I have to do this.
What about us?
What about everything we've been through? I'm sorry, I just couldn't help myself. After this, the next day comes and Mac, before she has to leave, wants to ride that long wave and decides to be a dirty pig and use the legendary family heirloom surferboard to ride that big 40-foot wave. As she is doing it, her grandpa looks at the waves and is like, something's not right here. And Brady only realizes that something's not going on because people are falling off their surfboards. I mean, you can't see the weather, look at the ocean. But then Brady tries to save Mac by going into the ocean where it's very dangerous and he needs to help his girlfriend. And they both die and drown. No, I'm only joking. They don't die. They actually, go into an alternate reality.
What did you do?
I tried to save you. This is the part where you tell me I'm your hero and then you shower me with kisses.
Yeah, my nigga, you're asking for too much, man.
What? Yeah?
Sunshine and sweet harmonies, time to play.
I know we've already played it like a lot of times, but I've got to play a little bit for you guys, man.
On my way, feeling fine. I can see my reflection in my surfboard shine.
Yo, man. Oh, that was cringe, man. Jesus.
Make a splash! Make a splash!
I am fucking fuming! Mega, mega fucking fuming!
What the hell was that voice?
Giggles!
After the whole singing and dancing, they all decide to go into Big Mama's.
Oh, that was awesome! I mean, insane! What up, dog?
Far out. He thinks we're animals.
No, it's an expression. It means, you know what, he's right, it does sound ridiculous.
And where are you cats from?
Oh, so cats is okay, but dogs is weird.
Just follow my lead.
Is it leading us home?
We're from, Far away.
Far away.
Right, not far, but,
But far. Yeah. A close far.
Hey, Rascal.
Yeah, see, cat?
Seems to me that we've got some unwanted hodad.
Hodads!
That we need to put the kibosh...
Kibosh! No, you've got it all wrong.
We don't jelly...
Jelly!
Roll to outsiders.
Basically, what my man's is trying to say is, if you walk like a up, talk like a up, smile like a up, then you must be a up. I'm sorry, J-Hus, for ruining it.
This is Big Mama's, the restaurant where the surfers and bikers all hang.
Bikers? What bikers?
Boss man thought he was so hard doing that, didn't he? But after the biker's amazing, spectacular, bad man introduction, they have the greatest, and I mean greatest, insult battle, playground battle you will ever hear in mankind.
Ciphers. Thought I smelled something fishy. Rodents.
I know I should have laid some traps.
Thought you were exterminated.
And I thought you ciphers was all washed up.
Yeah, because clearly, uses drifts.
You should make like the ocean and wave goodbye.
But after this amazing playground insult, the best song that may or may not made me use my parents' credit card to buy the whole soundtrack of this movie. Just listen.
Stand back.
Why?
You'll see.
Here we come, revving our engines under the sun. You're cruising for bruising. Whoa, keeping it cool, smooth and steady. So look back here, man, things are getting heavy. You're cruising.
gotta love the choreography in this movie, man, come on. We also get some beautiful lyricism from Layla.
Bubblegum, cherry pop, go to the hop. Hanging with my brother cause his friends are so hot while they're cruising for some bruising.
After witnessing greatness, all Mac cares about is going back and taking that flight to that boarding school that she therefore wants to go to. And Brady's just having the time of his life in his favourite movie. Mac's eagerness to go back home results into her changing the plot of the whole movie.
Hey, Giggles, those hips are so seismic.
It ain't moving, it's the problem, see, Cap?
Was I the only one that was scared of Giggle? Bloody hell. Anyway, back to the point.
Wait. I'm sorry, but I'm worried. I don't have time to wait around for the storm. I'm gonna head back to the beach and try and figure out out here.
No, Mac, remember? This is the part of the movie we saw at your grandfather's. Where the two leads get together?
You enjoy it. I'll let you know if I come up with anything.
Not really. Stage is like 2 feet up. The worst you would have done is broken a nail.
I guess I literally fell for you, huh? I'm Layla.
I know. I mean, yeah, you are. I've dreamed about this since I was like in fifth grade.
Who are you?
Brady, knight in shining board shorts.
Nigga, what? Brady's just an interesting character, ain't he?
Max, something's not right.
We can write a list of things that aren't right, starting with the fact that there are enough things to write a list.
Look around. Nothing's happening. It's almost dull.
Okay. And?
Okay, so when Layla sings that song about finding the perfect boy and being happy...
See, that's exactly my point. Why does she need a boy to be happy?
Sorry, Miss Feminist. After already fucking up one plot, they go check if they messed up another one, which is about an evil British man and an evil scientist making a weather machine to take over Big Mama's.
This machine will so drastically change the weather patterns, it will literally still the oceans, so there's no longer surf. It'll create humidity so dense, it'll rust every piece off of those shiny chrome machines. The surfers will leave to find a new spot to surf. The bikers won't come near this area ever again. And I shall triumph! Triumph, I say!
You will have the last laugh.
Yes, well, I've always been rather wary of the last laugh. I mean, what if it was only moderately funny?
And this thing never won an Oscar.
Hi.
Do you mind if I join you?
Of course not. I'd want to join you too. So, hey. No, I've never seen a chick quite like you.
Chick? Really? Hold on while I lay some eggs.
No.
So, Layla, how come you bikers don't get along with the surfers?
Oh. It's always been like that. We're not supposed to have a lot in common. Plus, we both want Big Mamas.
Some of them seem pretty cool, like, that guy Tanner.
It was very courageous of you to charge the stage like that and save my life.
Courageous? No.
Now, fuck me. No, I'm sorry. Well, anyway, after this, they all decide to sing a song about being together. Boff!
Plan B?
Jeez, the boss.
It's beautiful. Should I wear this to go see Brady? He loves to surf, and the water's blue. And this dress is blue, so the next time he goes surfing, he'll see the blue water and he'll think of me. Oh, my God. Why should a boy influence what you choose to wear? Or anything you do.
Of course, the feminists back at it again. But on the real though, why would you say something like that? You've already messed up the plot once, so why would you try it again by saying that? Don't let men tell them what to do! We are women! We are free! Next thing you know, they make a suffragettes organization and Layla gets trampled by a motorcycle to save all women.
Yeah, what's the matter with letting a boy be in control of things?
It's your life. You can decide what to do.
I decide to let boys decide.
We can do anything a guy can do.
I don't know where you're from, but around here, you have to ask a boy out without asking him. You know, like with your eyes.
Yeah, Layla, you're definitely correct. That's how my grandparents met in it. While my grandfather was out here trying to fetch the water, my grandma looked at his eyes and said... Then they got the water and they lived happily ever after. Terrible joke, innit? Well, after this, Brady chills out with the lads. They start talking about girls and that, and then another song that was the reason for why I may or may not have used my parents' credit card to buy the Teen Beach movie soundtrack comes on. Okay. And this was for kids, yeah? The big real surfing there, therefore not green screen. Mac and Brady try to restore order in this movie by making Layla and Tanner come back together, trying to fix the plot.
Okay, we need to get back into the lighthouse to try and stop him. But we need the element of surprise. Do you think we can get into it from the water?
Mac! Mac, you okay?
Hair.
Hair?
Hair! Hair!
Your hair isn't wet.
My hair isn't wet.
What does that mean?
Since they've been in the movie for so long, they're now morphing into the movie. Ooh.
So, we gotta get Layla and Tanner together. We have to make them find out about Les's machine and have them destroy it before it destroys them.
No. We're talking in plot points.
Going somewhere.
Let's go.
You're not going anywhere.
I know karate. And like... two other Japanese words.
Brady!
What did the movie just turn into? It just went from going into an alternate reality, messing up a plot, fixing up a plot, relationship troubles and all of that, to Brady getting shot.
We're gonna surf.
What? You like to surf?
I know. It's like riding a cloud, except the cloud is water.
No way! I said the same thing! Except, well, not right now.
I know that bikers aren't supposed to like surfing, but I don't care. Oh my gosh. I don't care.
You don't? Hey, you know what?
No, I don't know that either.
I've always wanted to ride a motorcycle.
Are you serious?
No, I'm Tanner.
I grew up riding.
Is that why you're stunning as a moon, lighteth up a day?
Jesus, man. Is this how Americans get girls? They fall in love, la-da-da-da-da, and then something weird just happens.
I gave this to Mac. She was wearing it.
Then why did she take it off?
Something's not right.
We need to get help!
They go to Big Mama's telling everyone exactly what happened, even though they wouldn't have known anyway, and the only clue they had was Mac's ring thingy that Tanner made.
Everyone listen!
Les Camembert wants to destroy us.
He's built a weather machine that will stop the tide.
And rust all of our bikes.
Just to get rid of us.
Plus, he has Mac and Brady held captive at a secret location.
We don't know where it is because it's a secret.
Oh, Brady!
Can I just say, for a movie based around Big Mama's place, she is pretty irrelevant in this movie, isn't she?
I mean, all of us!
Our only hope is to work together, free our friends, and destroy that weather machine before it destroys our world.
Just why?
Why should we do anything with them?
We didn't want to do anything with you first. Together we can help each other.
Yeah, well, why should we listen to you?
I never thought I'd have anything in common with a biker. That is, until I took a ride with one.
In fact, all that fighting ever did for us was stop us from seeing what we all have in common.
Big Mamas, the beach, and...
Fuck her right in her pussy!
Could be worse. At least my favorite movie wasn't Tarantulas on a Train.
Some beautiful acting right there.
Okay, you've lost it.
If we hadn't have come here, I'd be on the plane right now, heading to some private school to become something that I really don't want to be.
You don't, do you?
I spent this entire movie telling Layla to follow her heart and do what she loves.
Now you know that's cap. All you've been telling her to do is, we are women, we are free, we don't need men to do this, we don't need to do this for men, we are women.
So you're glad we came?
I couldn't be more glad. It's like, I'm tied up, but at the same time, I've never felt more free. You were right. What's the hurry to grow up? I could be stuck in 1962 with you.
When it's meant to be. You see, I don't want to see her lip syncing over someone else's singing, you see, so we're gonna skip, yeah? Anyway, the surfers and bikers come to save the day and go into the lighthouse and destroy the weather machine and save Mac and Brady. Ayo, boss, she's a teenager, you know. What kind of sugar daddy nonsense is this? Well, anyway, they do some unnecessary running, destroying, throwing, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And then they finally destroy the weather machine and leave the man behind.
I can't even imagine a scenario where this works out well for us. Nope.
Then they say their goodbyes and drown again and get back to their world. Oh no. And when they get home, Mac tells her aunt that she doesn't want to go to some dead ass boarding school. She wants to surf and see the waves, dude.
Mackenzie? Do you know what you've done? We are late for our flight, late for registration, totally off schedule, and also.
Aunt Antoinette, I love you. And Mom would be so happy that you care so much. But I think you've been wrong. I mean, my mom wouldn't want me to be successful like you. She'd want me to be happy doing what I love. Like you are doing what you love, but That's not what I love.
And then they all sing and dance, which makes zero sense because the whole point of their singing and dancing was because they were in an alternate reality, which was a musical, and now they're doing it in real life. And that's how the movie ends. Teen Beach Movie. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This is a little bit different from what I usually do. If you want more videos like this, just let me know. I really enjoyed making this video, so don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll catch you soon. OhMarDayz out.